to do item number five. Item number five is ordinance number 2013-12, to amend chapter 102, article 4, division 1 of the city code by adding a new section number 102 through 246, and to amend the city code section 102-243 concerning parking violations and penalties for non-compliance with certain parking requirements, both for the purpose of requiring that the curbside wheels of vehicles parked on the streets parallel to a curb shall be no more than 12 inches from such curb, and imposing a fine for the violation of such requirement.
Thank you very much, Madam Clerk. Mr. Angelasso, your paper, would you care to introduce?
Sure. Thank you very much, President Daniels. I introduced this at public safety. It's largely something that has to do with many of our older neighborhoods that have narrower streets and the fact that there's irregular parking patterns that has made travel lane a little bit less passable. It's been brought to my attention in many of our communities that having this ordinance asked would be beneficial both to drivers as well as those parked vehicles who open their car doors, as well as the cycling community that needs to share the roads along with our vehicles. The Virginia Driver's Manual echoes this language and says that drivers shall park their cars within 12 inches of the curb. Therefore, we're simply trying to follow through on the recommendations of the Virginia Department of Motor Vehicles. This has gotten some support from both our law enforcement officers who say that it helps to define how close a car should be parked to the curb. We've got high variability where some cars are parked as far as 4 feet from the curb. This will help provide law enforcement with a little bit of clarity so that when they are out there making a judgment, they've got better advice. The last point that I'd like to make is I do believe that this is an important ordinance to increase parking capacity in many of our older neighborhoods. If you have to have turning radius to pass a car that is 4 feet from the curb, it means that you need more space between your car and the car in front of you and the car behind you. And many of our neighborhoods already have parking issues, and I do believe that this can increase better utilization of the street parking. Lastly, we did make an amendment to the curb to define how this law would be applicable to streets that do not have a curb. So any street that does not have a curb, this law does not go into effect, and it's very clearly stated that it does not apply to streets without curbs.
Thank you, Mr. Ashcroft. Are there members of the public here tonight who wish to speak in opposition to this paper?
Good evening again. My name is Donald Hatcher. I have some problems because as a citizen of the city of Richmond, the police have come to my house and said to me, after someone hit my car, and my car was more than 24 inches from the curb, and he wanted to give me a ticket. That's my car, it's not 40 feet. When you're talking about my car parked more than 2 feet from the curb, there's something wrong in this city in many ways. However, now you want someone who's old and have the ability to only see so good. You now want them to carry a roof with them so they get out the car and make it up on the wheels from the curb. When you got a one-way street and there's plenty of room and cars parked on both sides for a car to go down the street. Now we talking about if it ain't no curb there. Well, you don't pay that car no mind. And for someone to park a car 4 feet from a curb, they got a serious problem with these wrong. Or they don't have a brain at all, or something is wrong. The only city doesn't get any better. But someone who lives here, they keep on seeing the foolishness and the people can come walking out the street and tear your house up, do whatever they want to your property. And you live in a black neighborhood, they can steal from you. The city don't see none of the trash and the filth all around the place. And sad what goes on in this city. And none of you sit here and can't see me come out of your neighborhood and walk around and see what's going on. I just don't understand. People in this city can't come into a house and walk to a bus stop. You better be ready to fight. Don't nobody see nothing. People hanging around all day with drugs and being drunk and don't have no issue about having anything to do with anything decent. And the jackknife brother Jesus Christ. And you probably have some people come down here and talk to you, but they don't like that. But we've been told all our lives, and I'm saying this on purpose, but you're going to have some people come down and tell you that you shouldn't be worshiping Jesus. There's the same religion in this town that plays that game. And I don't got smart enough to realize Jesus ain't never existed. So all y'all that believe in Jesus, I believe in God. I ain't going nowhere near Jesus. So you do what you want to do. But the citizens in this town deserve better. I know a man fits in and thinks he ain't got no income. You got a bunch of senior citizens living in this town that only get so much money to live on. Their houses are inadequate, they don't have insulation. And that's the problem, because the attic, the sidewalk, and the floor underneath the house is ice cold. Poor folks can't pay for so much. Poor folks being black in this city would be proud of making decent living. And it was done with the saying of nice white folks saying, well, we're not going to pay you so much. The foolishness in this country needs to stop. We all Americans. And I have seen that for 73 years, people want to play with you and sit in these seats. There ain't no joke nobody living out here in the house that's cold at night. It ain't no joke that you're going to come in my whole neighborhood and raise somebody to rent the $900 a month. How do people pay it? There's a lot of questions going on in this town. Y'all don't have to address it.
Okay. Here's my hand up.
You don't get this one where somebody's going to put some problems on that.
Thank you, Mr. Yeah. Other others here speak in opposition to the paper about parking closures or closing the curb. Seeing none. If you're one of the public tonight, would like to come and speak in support of this case. Good evening, my name is Phil Carson. It's 5 minutes to 9 p.m. I would like to speak in support of this paper, although I'd like to chastise both the council for a summary on the agenda and Mr. Agilato, my councilman, who I think is doing a very good job, and I appreciate our communication through Facebook that he's been sending out. He appears to me to be one of the hardest working council members on the council, and I appreciate that very much. I would urge all of you to make more of an effort, particularly through Facebook, to communicate information that's happening in the city with your constituents. But I'd like to speak in support of this paper, but what I'm chastising the council and Mr. Agilato for is not being clear. You should tell the citizens of the city you're going to be fined $20 if you park more than 12 inches from the curb. That's simple. You're going to be fined $20 if you park more than 12 inches from the curb. Citizens of Richmond, Virginia, you will be fined $20 if you park more than 12 inches, 1 foot from the curb. I just want to make that clear to the people, the city of Richmond, and I would urge you guys to do something about the summary of the ordinances and the resolutions you provide to the public, because it's not clear what's going on here. And you guys can do a better job. You guys can explain the papers that you're introducing yourselves. The mayor, he can have members of his administration come to the committee meetings and explain papers that he's introducing. I went to a committee meeting last week where the mayor did not provide an individual, although there were members and staff in the room. He provided a paper, a simple trade for a paper, accepting park money from some state agency to support parks in the city. You know, the mayor should provide explanations of papers he's introducing, and you all should do a better job explaining the papers that you're proposing. Thank you.
Any other speaking in favor of this paper? Seeing none, I'll bring it back to council for discussion. Right away, people would park on both sides of the street. However, it seems
regardless of what the other jurisdictions have done. I'm not sure how that impedes the number of parking spaces since you would be parallel park. So I'm sensitive to the fact that other districts have a much more difficult parking situation than my district has. But as someone that lives this day in and day out of parking, fellow parallel parking in front of my home, I think this is too strict for parking, and I cannot support this. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Gentleman. No other comments? Mr. Bond?
I have a question for Mr. Adelata. Looking here at the report, cities all over the state have this law already in place. Chesapeake County has an ordinance that says 18 inches off the curb, and some of the others are 12 inches. Norfolk is the closest. How is 12 decided on? Strawberry Street is much narrower than, say, Carytown. Whoever in Carytown is a professional sport, much in some people parallel park. The road is wider, so 12 inches, if they were further off, they may not be in violation. But they would be if this were passed, but it may not be impeding traffic flow if we're going to start with. Is there a determination of 12 versus 18?
Thank you, Mr. Wiles. The determination for 12 inches was done by our staff, looking at various ordinances passed by other jurisdictions, and they did a survey across the state. Most municipalities were issuing 12 inches. Chesterfield was the only one that gave a greater width for its definition of 18 inches. Norfolk was the narrowest at 6 inches. What we settled on was what was recommended in the Department of Motor Vehicles Drivers Manual. This is the standard that all drivers in the state of Virginia are tested on. And this is what I think most people would reference as best practice. And that's where we determined the 12 inches. However, I do want to make sure that everybody understands that this ordinance is to work with the existing ordinances that police have the discretion to determine whether or not a parked vehicle is obstructing the right-of-way. They can determine a parked vehicle is obstructing the right-of-way even if it's an inch from the curb. That's the discretion and power that they currently have. What we're trying to do is provide a little bit more uniformity so that more people understand what we think is the best thing.
Thank you.
Other questions? Mr. President, or actually, excuse me, other comments from council members?
Yeah,
Mr. President?
Yeah, I just, I hear the parking concerns. However, I think Mr. Hatcher made a good point. And then as you go out to the neighborhood, it's very senior people. Sometimes don't get away. And I think Paul said, Mr. Wellsmith, 12 inches on Carey Street is very different than 12 inches on Strawberry Street. So
speaking on Mr. Angelasso, I'm going to give you the last word. I can count to a certain number. Would you have any interest in continuing this? How do you feel about public safety?
I'd be happy to continue it, public safety. However, I would also encourage my fellow members of the city council to come to me when you've had some concerns, because I'm available. We don't need to do this necessarily in disguise. So please contact me at any time if you have a concern or if one of your constituents has a concern about a paper that I might introduce. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. If there is no other comments from council, is there a motion? Would you move to continue this paper to the next council meeting after public safety, after this paper be sent back to public safety? I hear it. Do I hear Mr. Wells give a second?
Yes.
Wonderful. Madam Clerk.
Oh,
yes, Madam Clerk.
Council is voting on item number 5, ordinance number 2013-12, to have that paper go to the February 26th Public Safety Standing Committee meeting as the March 11th Council meeting.
And, Mr. President, tomorrow's not a public safety meeting, so we can't meet tomorrow, have to be in March.
To the March Public Safety meeting then? Ms. Kimball, are you amending your motion so that it is continued to the next council meeting after your March public safety meeting? Okay. Is there a second to this amendment to the motion?
Second.
I think Mr. Bloss seconded. Madam Clerk, let's go again on this question, please.
Council is voting on item number 5, ordinance 2013-12, to go to the March 19th public safety meeting and before council again on March the 28th. Mr. Wells?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Abdelwaston?
Aye.
Mr. Gilbert?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Dr. Newville?
Aye.
President Samuels?
Aye.
That motion is passed. That paper will be before the Public Safety Committee on March 19th and before Council on March 28th.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. Do we continue with regular?
Item number 28.